coast to coast. To the front row.
Yeah. located on 9 o'clock. Yes. Girl, you better come to my eyelash this night. What are you gonna do? You can't walk in there anymore?
Look up. I think she made a little tighter. The rest
of okay. On the table somewhere. Find it. Give me a chapstick brush, please. Because it's gonna dry out.
Really?
Veronica, Veronica,
Happy birthday!
The red badge, you can see the hole on the top of the bag. That's a black dog. That's the only black dog in it with the budget. Can you go right now for the team? Fuck, the Lord has made, man. You should get him. Oh, the Lord has made, man. Some people stay single forever. Hello? 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 Hey, I'm just here.
the church. Peace.
Look at the bottom. Look.
Oh, For what?
Veronica.
Okay, now, hallelujah.
Amen.
Come in now yourself. With
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
you are happy to be here, say amen.
Amen.
Reason why we are happy is because of the fact that God is bringing together two wonderful, wonderful people, and through them, great things will happen. Amen.
Amen.
This is marriage. This is a union between a man and a woman. In this modern society, there are unions, and some are pushing for other unions, but that's not why we are here. We are here for the real one.
Yes.
Marriage is between a man and a woman, and that is what we have to understand. I'm not going to waste much words, but I'm going to advise my brother and my son, my daughter, and everybody here, based upon the word of God, that this marriage is a very serious thing, and it should never be taken lightly. I'm going to base my presentation, very short, on three scriptures. And the first scripture is coming from Genesis chapter 2, verse 21 through 24. If someone can help me read that, that would be fine. Genesis 2, 21 through 24. Amen. I think I have to read it myself. Everybody is in the mood for something. Where's my glasses? Scriptures, but I will read only two. The third one, I will tell you what is there. And then we find out whether we can learn some lessons from the word of God that will bless us and bless our dear brother. First reading is from Genesis chapter 1, chapter 2, verse 21 to 24. It says, and the Lord God caused deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept, and he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman, and he brought her to the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Say amen.
Amen.
The second reading is from Ephesians chapter 5. And verse 22. It says, wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. For the husband is head of the wife, as also Christ is head of the church, and he is the Savior of the body. Therefore, just as the church is subject to Christ, so let wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her, that he might sanctify and cleanse her with the washing of the word, water by the word, that he might present her to himself a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. So husbands ought to love their own wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For no one ever hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, just as the Lord does the church. For we are members of his body, of his flesh, and of his bones. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.
Amen.
This is a mystery, great mystery. But I speak concerning Christ and the church. Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his own wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband. Amen.
Amen.
Bow down your heads. Almighty God, in the name of Jesus Christ, your Holy Son, we thank you for this sacred moment. We thank you for your presence and power. We thank you for your glory. We thank you for your privilege that you have given us in Jesus. We thank you for all that you have done and continue to do and about to do. As I share your word, I pray that the hearts of the bride and the groom will be open, that you will drill this word into their hearts, and it will bear fruit for the glory of your name. And so are all those who are witnesses here, that your word will bless them, that they will move from one level of victory to another, one level of glory to another, one level of blessing to another. In the holy name of Jesus, I have spoken, and be it done. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I would like to talk briefly on the subject, selection of a wife. How to select a wife. In the case of my brother Charles, the selection is made. But if you are here and the selection is not made, I'm going to give you a few things that will help you to select a wife or a husband. Because as a matter of fact, the future of the marriage depends upon the selection. And a lot of people believe that when you select somebody bad, then in the course of things are going to get better. It is not. The selection is the most important part of the marriage framework or the marriage institution. So let us look at what God has said in His Word. First of all, selecting the most beautiful woman in the whole world, the most lovely woman in the whole world for yourself is not an easy task. It's very difficult. My brother, once you have brought this lady before God, you are telling God and the angels in heaven, all this crowd of witnesses and even demons and principalities who are running this world, that this lady is your wife.
Amen.
To select a woman to be your life partner is very serious. I'll give you a few reasons. The first reason why you have to view or approach this issue with all the seriousness it deserves is number one. God says, for this reason, you will leave your father and your mother and you will cleave to your wife. You will be glued to your wife. Should you approach such an event lightly? A woman, a lady, your wife, because of that, you see, you will leave your parents and be joined to your wife. Very serious. Peter says it's a very serious business because you have to love her. The Bible say, didn't say you have to understand her. It says you have to love her. And if you look at the commandments of God, he said love her. And then it comes back, he says love your wife. So if you look at what God wants you to love, it's God first and your wife. Say amen.
Amen.
And loving somebody is not easy. So it's a very important thing. But anything that involves love involves your heart. And anything that you are going to do and your heart is involved must be viewed as a very serious thing. You cannot enter into marriage lightly. Scripture says you must nourish her and you must cherish her. It means that you have to make a very, 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 very serious, take a very serious look at the woman that you select as your wife. Scripture says that the bride should be spotless, without spot or wrinkle. It means the lady must have some quality, some character. Without spot or wrinkle simply means the woman you select must have some character. And that is why you have to approach the whole concept of marriage as a very serious one. Scripture says the two of you are going to become one flesh. It is only in spiritual mathematics that 1 + 1 is equal to 1. And it's spiritual. And if you look at the whole thing, 1 + 1 should be 2. But in the eyes of God, 1 + 1 is what? Is 1. And that makes it a very hard thing. And so you cannot approach marriage lightly. It is very important. Because God says, leave your parents, those who, you know, brought you into this world, and then be joined. Let me give you an example of how to select a woman. In Genesis chapter 24, there's a beautiful story there. Abraham had a son of promise, and his name is Isaac. Isaac's mother passed away. Abraham was very old, and he looked at his sorrowful son, and he said, my son needs a wife. That tells you that marriage involves your parents.
Amen.
Abraham was involved in Isaac's marriage. So as you sit down here, I believe with all my heart that your parents have endorsed what you are about to do. Amen.
Amen.
So he called his servant and said, my servant, give me a promise. Touch me in the thigh. Give me a promise that my son Isaac will not be married to any of the women of the Canaanites. And the servant gave that promise, touched Abraham. The Canaanites worshipped many gods, one different sacrifices and strange things. And so Abraham said, you know what to do? Go back to Mesopotamia, the land between two rivers, to my own people. And the lesson there is, the background of the woman you select, the background of the man in your life is very important. So he said, my servant, go back and bring someone from my own family and my own people. Two of you must have a common background. And that is, you believe that Jesus Christ was conceived of the Holy Spirit. He was born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate. He was betrayed. He was crucified. He died. And he was buried. And on the third day, he was raised again from the dead. Because you have this common background, you can move on in life.
Amen.
Satan said, don't bring anybody up with all this Antonia must stop. In Ghana, government officials and big people are consulting Antonia man. Please pray for Ghana. But the devil is preparing that country for a showdown. And people will cry if we don't pray. But let me tell you something. When you marry a woman, when you select a woman, you don't marry only the woman, you marry all the spirits in her background. You marry the grandmother, the grandfather, everybody is in it, and the vice versa. So the background is very, very important. But I thank God that you have a common background. And that common background is faith in Jesus Christ. Abraham's servant, when he was assigned that responsibility, he found it very difficult. I remember when I was a teacher in Ghana, and one teacher who used to write a lot of books, he said when he was at the teacher's college, there was something they called teaching practice. And he wrote some vocabulary, some new words on the board. And one of the words was difficult. And so he said, who is in this classroom who can form a sentence with the word difficult? Then the kids, teacher me. Again, too. Teacher, monkey's bottom is difficult. Brother Charles, this is difficult. Abraham's servant, you know what? This is an impossible task. So what did he do? He called upon the name of God. He says, Lord God of my master Abraham, I have given assignment. This assignment is more than I can handle. Take me, lead me to the person who should marry Isaac. And scripture says, when he prayed, God listened. Wife selection demands a lot of prayer. I believe that Brother Charles, you have prayed. I got to check with you. I see you every Sunday. I see you praying hunger. I know you believe God. And you have to pray. And you have prayed. You have asked the God of heaven, El Elohim Israel. You have spoken to God. And he shall place his name on your heart. When the servant prayed, he took 10 camels, gold and silver and everything. I hope you have gold. Get there. And then he prayed again as we were getting to the outskirts of the city. He said, Lord God Almighty, here is a well. I have 10 camels and other people. We are tired. We need water to drink. Any woman who comes here, and I approach her, and I say, woman, give me some water to drink. And without saying anything further, if the woman looks around, sees my camels and my friends, and tells me, not only you, but I will water your camels, let that woman be the wife of Isaac. Yes. Put your hand together for the woman. Prayer is not important. Yes. Some people can pray. If you sing and you don't pray, I know. If you dance and you don't pray, I can tell. Yes. If you preach and you don't pray, I can tell. Amen. If you play the conga or the guitar or the lead or the rhythm and you don't pray, I can tell. Amen. Prayer is anointing. It brings the ability of God into your life so that the devil cannot dance with your life. Amen. People who pray, they know their God. Amen. And those who know their God, they will do brilliantly. The guy prayed like that, and there came a young lady, beautiful. In fact, scripture says, beautiful, good looking. You know, some people, they are good looking, will get into their head, and they will not even talk to you. I remember one time I got to an elevator, and I saw this young, I said, oh, good morning. So, oh, what is good about this morning? So since then, I don't say anything again. Hallelujah. Yeah. A beautiful lady. So, lady, can I have a little drink? For sure. She went to the world. Some of my money will send it to you for her. But I'm going to get a
yes,
sir. Rebecca said, yes, my Lord. She went in, first of all, she finished looking in the eyes of the sun and said, oh, wait, you're going to water all the 10 camels. Yeah. And give us water to your friends. Yeah. And you are talking about 10 camels that have walked over thousands of miles. So how many times do you think Rebecca went to the well to water the camel? On camels. She didn't know the fact. But right there, you can tell the character of the woman. And as soon as that happens, the guy said, oh, bingo. Thank you, my Lord God. Yeah. The God of my master Abraham.
Amen.
And the story went for.
Amen.
Amen. lady said, okay. Then the servant said, who are you? I want your identity. Brother Chad, you know the identity of this lady. Amen.
Amen.
He said, I am the daughter of Bethuel. And my mother is Milka, and my father is Nahor, the brother of Abraham. Hey! Imagine. Tell me more. He said, let's get home. You will have straw for your camels, a place to sleep, and everything. And if you look, I want to cut the story short. When the story came to the climax, where the servant told his mission, you know, but let's don't forget, he said, let us give you something to eat. Enjoy yourself. Then tell us your mission. He said, no, I am not going to eat until I have told you my mission. A lot of Christians, they can't move anywhere, can't hear anything because they eat too much. They forget that they are spiritual people. They forget that they should be on their knees. I mean, the guy, when he saw the food, I mean, he could have all forget it. Let me enjoy myself. He said, no. Sometimes we must tell food, no. I am not going to eat until I have my breakthrough, until I have prayed the whole day, until I have seen a change in my daughter's life, until I have seen a change in my husband's life. Let me tell you, sometimes you have to speak to food as a food. Keep quiet, shut your mouth. And let me see God first.
Amen.
The Bible gave his message. And listen to those who are listening. He said, this thing is of the Lord.
Yes.
After the spirit, this thing is of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, point your finger here. Everybody say, this thing
is
of the Lord.
It's of the Lord.
Amen.
Sometimes spend some time sleep, spend 10 days. He said, no, 10 days too much. I have to take this lady. Now, listen to this part of the story. Before her departure, I won't go to Egypt. They prayed with her. They gave her rings, their nose rings, and bracelets, and everything. And you know what happened? I like about Rebecca. They called Rebecca and said, Rebecca, do you want to go with this man so that you can go get married to Isaac? He said, oh yes, I will come. I believe, sister Anas, you will go home.
Two verses. Let her descendants be thousands and thousands and thousands. And as I speak under the anointing of the Spirit, may God open her womb. Then the next part, he says, may her descendants possess the gates of your enemies. May the Almighty God give you what it takes. Possess the gates of your enemies. Anything that lies up against you, my soul. In the mouth or eye, wicked eyes, whatever, that will be lifted up against you. May the Lord of all my life give you what it takes.
Oh, Jesus.
And defeat your enemies. Of God is that your enemies can't conquer you.
Yes.
If you are a Christian and your enemies are bothering you too much, watch it. According to God's word, you must possess the gate of your enemies.
Amen.
Then they blessed Rebecca.
Amen.
He didn't know the servant. By faith, he followed.
Yes.
He brought this young lady, and you know, Isaac was also walking around in the field. Oh, when my he was looking forward. Her mother had passed away, very sorrowful. Needed comfort. And so when they said your wife was coming, each other's like, oh my God, when is it going to happen? When is it going to happen? And then he stretched his neck and he saw the cameras coming. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And then Rebecca said, who is that man in the field looking at us? That is the guy.
That is the guy.
And when they brought Rebecca to the house, Scripture says, he took Rebecca into his tent. Take her to your tent.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And Scripture says, Rebecca took 40 years.
Yeah.
You are the mother. You are the mother.
Amen.
You are the sister.
Amen.
You are everything.
Yes.
You are his comfort.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when Paul was talking, he said, the flesh confesses to the living one. But he said, but I tell you a mystery. Look, Jesus Christ is our heavenly Isaac. The church is his bride. The Holy Spirit is going around taking wives for Jesus. And Scripture says, he wants to present you without blemish or without spot or wrinkle. If you are truly saved, if you are walking in the Spirit, there's something the Spirit must do for you.
Amen.
Paul says, the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free.
Amen.
From the law of sin.
Amen.
And death.
Amen.
So that when you appear before the Lord, your heavenly Isaac is waiting. He has sent the servant to look for you. And the servant has put gold, bracelets, adorning you, preparing you for the day that the Holy Spirit will present you to Jesus. Jesus says, make sure that your dress, your wedding dress, is without spot or wrinkle. That is to the church. So when you are in the church, it's not only the church that I'm speaking about, everybody doing that. But I make sure that your wedding garment on that day when you meet Jesus is pure.
Amen.
It is clean.
Amen.
It is clean.
Amen.
It is clean.
Amen.
Because you are not living according to the sins of the world. I'm not driving you out here, but I have to tell you the truth. It says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Brother Charles, I'm ending this presentation on this note. God says the two flesh must dwell, but one. And Paul quoting God in Ephesians said the same thing. The two must be one.
Yes.
Shall we say that? The two must be one. And I'm going to finish. Four areas where you cannot be one with your one. One is physical. That is what you see. And then you go to that and you see. You are just too many. You go. You are going to woman. It means you are going to have sex.
Yes.
You're looking at me. You are going to hold her hand.
Amen.
And when two of you go to the grocery and you have a whole lot of things, now expect them to be carrying the meat. You are going to use your muscles.
Amen.
I know a young man who came from Ghana, married to somebody I know, and then they went to grocery, they buy a soda. He said, hey, my husband helped me. He said, hey, who can some baby go for America? So in this country, that's all there was some. Many of my cousins are not sure.
Oh my goodness.
You you feel me, I'm a girl, I'm not going to be single first.
Physical, eye to eye, hand to hand.
Oh, hallelujah.
That means you are going to bond with her.
Amen.
That's number one. Number two, spiritually, you are going to be one with her. Means this week we are going to stop something.
You are going to pray.
Yes.
You are always to pray.
When the Holy Spirit, that
I'm going to see you when you want, and that is true prayer.
Let me tell you, if I preach and I give you such a setup from my job, or for this setup from this, it won't work.
Unless you know how to pray.
Amen.
Because if you pray, you do not go to God.
If you pray, grace is released upon your life. There are certain things you can never solve with your own understanding. There are problems beyond human ability. Imagine you standing at the Red Sea, and the devils surrounding you, the devils after you. What are you going to do? And at that time, you need the hand of God. You need the hand of God. And the only thing that can bring the hand of God upon your life or marriage
is prayer. Spiritually, you will be one in the prayer.
Number three, economically, the purse. Say one purse. If the two flesh is one, then the purse is what?
Is one.
That is one. That is one. That is one. That is
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you have spiritually one, physically you are one, economically you are one another.
Yes.
That's what God is talking about.
Amen.
So I leave you with the word of God. Based upon what God has said, let your unity be strong.
Amen.
Anything that you would do, that will try to place us with God's truth. Stay in the unity that God has commanded in marriage. So that the two will be one flesh. And if you are one flesh, if somebody says, I'm aware that somebody is somebody is having you and I have, you know. Or your husband is somewhere, God has opened it, you do know. I leave you. As Jesus said, I and my Father, we are one. Brother Charles and Sister Nance, you are one.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Let's say amen.
Yeah.
Let's say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now we are about to go home. You know, I'm going to say something. Can you tell me that? Huh? What is that? Sex. The moment he mentions sex. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Read the scripture. Abraham and Sarah went in.
thank you so very much.
God bless you. That is the only thing that churches don't talk about. We are afraid to talk about sex. Yes! And the sex was made for believers.
Hallelujah.
But I think I told you people that the next day of the sun, I'm going to for Junior. Pastor has done it. If you don't give me Junior and Sun in the back, say, Ivan, we are far gone.
So it's time for us to move forward. I'm going to call on my brother from different mall. He is one, and I am a hunter.
Brother, you are the much. Very much.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. May I invite you to come forward?
May we invite you to come forward.
I wish we could have an all night. Amen. It's hot. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We should better stop having weddings in air condition. We should have weddings in a hot place like this. So that when you get out of here, you know that you've been somewhere.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
We give God the praise, we give God the glory. Bishop, we thank you for the powerful word. And we've come to a very important aspect of our service today. Hallelujah. Our Reverend read from the book of Genesis. And the NIV says, the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. And while he was sleeping, he took one of the man's ribs and closed up the place with flesh. Then the Lord God made a woman from the rib he had taken out of the man. And he brought her unto the man. The man said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man. For this cause, or for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they will become one flesh. Here we see the first wedding, and we can conclude from this account in Genesis that God presented five things. I want you to understand the word I've come, but understand this, because it's very important as you make this covenant or these vows. You have to understand what you are doing. In this context, we see that marriage is God's, or marriage was God's idea, designed and instituted by the Creator. Marriage was not man's idea. Today, it has become man's idea. That is why man can manipulate marriage and think that you can do it anyhow. But reading from the verse, we see that marriage was God's idea. Amen.
Amen.
Marriage was the first, the only institution that was created before sin came into the world. And that is the reason why the devil is fighting marriages so much. Understand this. Number two, marriage is between a man and a woman. Amen.
Amen.
Marriage was the first, the only institution that was created before sin came into the world. And that is the reason why the devil is fighting marriages so much. Understand this. Number two, marriage is between a man and a woman.
Hallelujah.
We heard it. So shall a man leave his father and a mother. Marriage is not for boys and girls. Amen. Today, there are 40-year-old boys and 30-year-old girls. Amen. They are grown in stature, but their mind, their emotion, nothing of their being are grown. I was counseling somebody a few days ago. And the man keeps talking about my mother. Every minute, and my mother, and my mother, and my mother. And I said, you saw your mother. Why did you marry your mother? And he said, my father, if I were to be in the house, my mother would not treat me like that. My father would not cook this food for me, and that and that. You are going to make a covenant today. Amen. And so understand what you are getting yourself involved.
Praise the Lord.
May I invite the congregation to be on their feet? Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together, witness and celebrate the holy matrimony of our brother Charles and our sister Anas. True marriage is more than joining the bonds of marriage of two people. It is the union of two hearts. It lives on the love you give each other and never grow old. Marriage is love. Love should have no other desire but to fulfill itself. To melt and to be like it is rain that broke that sings its melody to the night. May you be blessed with a lifetime of happiness, a home of warmth and understanding. Today you are about to declare your commitment to each other. Before God, Father, and the East witnesses. St. Paul commanded marriage to be honorable among all men. And there it is not to be entered unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, soberly, and in the fear of God. Into these holy estates, you two come out to be joined. In any man that show any just cause, why Charles and Anas may not be lawfully joined together, let him now speak or hereafter hold your peace.
I have never seen anybody living in the child and but I'm here for us. You need to hear that somebody will be taken. No.
Charles and Anas, I reply and charge you both as you will answer at the dreadful day of judgment when the secret of all hearts shall be disclosed. That if either of you know any impediment why you may not be lawfully joined together in holy matrimony, ye do now confess it. You know anything that should hinder you, we'll be willing to go.
Amen.
Charles, will thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep only unto her as long as ye both shall live? If that is your desire, say, I will. May the Lord be my helper.
I will. May the Lord be my helper.
Anas, will thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance, in the holy estate of matrimony? Will thou obey him, serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep only unto him as long as ye both shall live? If that is your desire, say, I will. May the Lord be my helper.
I will be the Lord. the second string and say, we want to get married. We want to know who gave this woman to be married. Who gave this woman to be married? Oh, you are there. That is your man. We want to know if Charles has performed all customary rites and make sure that he has met all the desires of the Akuntas. Amen.
Amen.
Listen to me. We are all Ghanaians. No, not all Ghanaians. I mean, we are. But listen to me. In our culture, I don't know, I am a Ghan. In my culture, this is not a marriage. The marriage is the one that was done in the mother's house, in the family. You understand?
Yes, sir.
So if you fail to honor the father, the mother, and the family, we can bless the marriage.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Oh God.
Daddy, I want you to come and take the hand of your daughter. Take the hand of your daughter. Take the right hand of your daughter. Take the right hand of your daughter. And then give her to Charles.
Yes, sir.
Charles, listen to me. I didn't give, or any of the pastors here didn't give Anna to you. Who gave Anna to you? Daddy, you must never forsake or neglect this man and the Bible. You hear me? Okay. Charles, I want you to say this after me. Mention your name.
I just want to
thank you. Mention her name.
Thank me, Anastasia. This is
Ask my wedded wife. To come and to hold. From this day forward. For better or worse. For richer or poorer. In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death.
Till death.
Do as part.
Do as part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
And thereto.
I plight thee my soul.
I'm glad you, my friend.
Don't be anxious. Relax. Okay.
I know. It's for you. So take your own time.
Those of you who are here who are married, you did the same thing. You are also nervous.
Yes.
Some of you even put it off.
Yeah. Wanted to make it.
Give the mic to the woman.
I'm Anastasia, AC Adam.
Take thee,
Charles, I'm Anastasia.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's
holy ordinance. holy ordinance.
And thereto, I plight thee, my soul.
My soul.
You see, she's speaking English. I'm speaking Ghanaian English, and you are speaking Israeli English. Where you born in America?
She asked for to pray.
Our children are killing us, but we need to go home. Laugh and let get attention out. Let me tell a joke for you to laugh. One day a friend, a Ghanaian friend met, if you're a Ghanaian, you can't hide. The moment they see you, they know that we're Ghanaian. A Ghanaian brother met another Ghanaian young sister in an elevator and said, "Oh, it is there." And then the lady said, You talking me? And then the brother said, "Ghana for her. Not from her. How are you moving me? Put the gun and the cheek. Put the cheek. You talking me?
Right here. Hallelujah. And I'm going to pray.
Hallelujah.
Anyway, let us all begin to pray. Let's instead of talking,
yes,
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, I call upon you this moment and this hour, as I lift these wings before you, and hoping of love between us and us, before these wings are estate and put from them, I pray, O Lord, first of all, by the blood of Jesus, by the name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Spirit, sanctify this ring, sanctify this ring, sanctify this ring, anoint this ring, let this ring be a source of power, a sense of attraction between the two of them. Let this ring be a reminder, oh, between the two of them, that they belong to one another. So long as they have this ring on, let their love grow from one level of grace to another. From one level of love to another, this he has in the name of Jesus. And now we, you were made by a goldsmith. If the hand of this goldsmith has anything that has polluted this ring, I sanctify this ring in the blood of Jesus. Sometimes I give this ring in the blood of Jesus. And I ask the Holy Spirit to anoint the rings. In the name of Jesus, I pray and pray with that here. Amen.
As you put your ring on the third finger, cameras, are you ready? Take your time, take your time, take your time. Don't rush. Don't break the hand, please. Don't break the hand. Don't bring them
out
here, please, your
time. First time, please wipe
your
face for me.
And say this after me, as you put the ring gradually into the hand of Anas, with this ring, where is the mic? Where is the MC? Where is the mic? We want to hear Shana's voice. With this ring.
With this ring.
I did wear.
I did wear.
With my body, I did give. With my heart,
I did cherish.
And with all my worldly goods,
I did endow.
With all that I am,
I give unto you.
With all that I have,
I share with you.
From this day, until forever done.
Until forever done.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. With all that I am, I give unto you.
I give unto you.
With all that I have,
with all that I have,
I share with you.
I share with you.
From this day, until forever done.
Until forever done.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Those that God have joined together, let no man, no man put asunder. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and his witnesses, and thereto have given and pledged their troth, each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving ring, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are man and wife in the name of the Father. The greater blessing you can give to these people is your prayer. I want you to close your eyes, stretch out your hand, and send forth the word of prayer. That God will sustain and keep this marriage. And God will protect them and bless this marriage. Shall we all begin to pray? Pray right now. Pray right now in the name of Jesus. Let them never one day regret.
effect of this marriage. A lot of people are going around regretting their marriages.
Yes.
But Charles and her love will never regret.
Yes.
They will always rejoice.
Yes.
They will not endure, but they will enjoy.
Yes.
They will not endure this marriage,
yes,
but they will enjoy the marriage.
Yes, sir.
I give you praise and glory.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Where the musician gives us a song, while they sign, while they're ready. And
Thank you. business certificate to you. Let's welcome
Anastasia, Arjun, and Charles Arjun. Charles and Sammy. This is a certificate of recognition of marriage. I'm going to present it to you, Anastasia and Charles and Sammy, today. In the name of Jesus, I pray that you will be successful in whatever you do. I pray that you will grow to love your husband.
Amen.
You will grow to love your wife.
Amen.
May you be blessed and be fruitful.
Amen.
And multiply.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I give you this certificate in the name of the Father,
yes,
of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yeah.
Church, family, friends, behold Mr. and Mrs. Ansani.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Salam, please. I'm going to ask my dear brother in Christ, Brother Takin, evangelist, to give the benediction. Oh, Aki Takiko. Okay, former Akrishan. Akrishan, please give us the benediction, please.
Hallelujah. Let's worship the priest. The priest. Jesus Christ. The Lord. The
follow me, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Please stand. Oh, what are you for? Please stand. Don't move. Land Mrs. and Mr. and Wakawofos. Meet before you leave. Oh, man, come on, what do you pray? Come on, you see it to me, baby. Walk on, take the cowboys.
Sour, say no day, oh yeah, me jiffy. The bomb
wash and the bottom. Oh yeah, Emmanuel, Yamini and Wall. Me one the new man, Jesus wash and the bottom.
Yes, yes, yes.